So the next topic now is intramural and extramural. These two terms are made up of two Latin words each, that is intra and muralis, whereas the other one is extra and muralis. The term intra means inside or within, whereas the term muralis means walls. The term extra means outside, and the term muralis is walls. So basically, intramurals are the competition which take place within the walls of an institution, whereas extramurals are the ones which take place outside of the institution. This includes inter-house, inter-class, etc., whereas extramurals include inter college or school matches. So moving on to our next topic, that is objectives of intramurals. Written here are the five basic objectives of intramurals, starting with the first one, that is mass participation of students. Mass participation of students increases the amount of physical fitness. In one go, we can involve a huge amount of students. Secondly, brotherhood amongst the institution, and as well as unity in between the students of an institution. The second is, it develops the leadership qualities. How? For example, we have 200 students total, out of which we will be making 20 teams. Each team will have a leader. So we have 20 leaders. For 5 different events, we will be having 20 different captains in each event. So 20 into 5 is equal to 100. So we are developing a quality of leadership in 100 students by organizing intramurals for 1 year. The next is recreation source. As discussed earlier in this chapter, sports can be a recreation source for someone who is into his academics. So recreation is using time differently but in a productive manner. The next is talent identification. Out of the 200 students, 100 students have the zeal to represent the team of the institution in various other areas. But it is something next to impossible to organize trials for 100 students every week or every month. So intramurals helps us in identifying students who are good in different sports. Some might be good in cricket, some in football, some in kabaddi, whereas some is basketball. So intramurals help us in identifying talented students. The last is to develop organizational skills. Whenever intramurals are organized, either a house or a group or a class is made and in charge of organizing a specific event. By organizing intramurals, students come to know or they are made aware of various aspects of an event organization. This is how, by organizing intramurals 1 year, we can affect the lives of the students in a very positive as well as in a productive manner. So moving on to the next topic, that is objectives of extramurals. Written here are the 5 basic objectives of extramurals, starting with the first one, that is improves the standard of sports. By participating in extramurals, we come across various talented players as well as strong teams. And there's a simple rule in sports: if you want to excel, either you play with talented players or you face strong teams. Only these two things, in addition with your efforts and sincerity, help you become a better sportsman. The second is provides exposure. While going out and facing various talented players and strong teams, the students or the players are exposed to the outer sporting world. And sports is the only field where you can be a world champion. So if you perform in extramural competitions, firstly you will get talented player, secondly your team will become strong, and third you will be famous. The next is it develops sportsmanship. In intramurals, we discuss sportsmanship amongst the student is increased. So intramurals help in increasing sportsmanship within the walls of an institution, whereas extramurals helps in increasing sportsmanship in between institutions. One increases sportsmanship amongst the students within the walls of an institution, whereas the other one increases sportsmanship in between the institutions, or we can say students of various other institutions. The next is base of sports is made. When we go to participate in extramural competition, we lay a foundation stone in an institution of sports. And watching the seniors practice or play, the upcoming generation or the juniors, they feel a sense of motivation, they feel a sense of pride, as the students of the primary wing, or we can say the middle wing, they copy their seniors, or we can say this, they copy the students of the senior wing. So if the senior wing helps in laying a foundation stone, it will give fruits in the coming future. And the last is knowledge of new skills and rules. During intramurals, the rules are modified and made easy for mass participation. Whereas when it comes to extramurals, all the latest rules as well as the talented players show the various new skills which can be used for performing in a better manner. So this is how extramurals affect all these kind of things, but in a very positive manner. So moving on to the last topic of this chapter, that is specific sports program. Now, these specific sports program are not related to intramurals or extramurals, but these programs are the ones which are not related to any sort of competition. The main aim of these kind of competitions is to either enhance the level of health, or to bring awareness, or to create unity among the citizens of a state or a country. These specific sports programs are further divided into five types. They are Sports Day, Health Runs, Run for Fun, Run for Unity, and Run for Cause. So the first specific sports program is Sports Day. It enhances the level of sports in an institution. As discussed earlier, it helps us in making out talented sportsmen. Also, for this, a specific day is selected on which various events take place simultaneously. Simultaneously means, imagine this is a sports ground. This is a basketball court. A football field. Kabaddi court. And a tennis. In one go, we'll be having four different events. That is, on the basketball court, we'll be having a basketball match going on. Same is with kabaddi, tennis, and football field. The basic aim is to involve maximum amount of students, which obviously increases their level of fitness, as well as it develops the amount of unity in between students, as all of them play for a common goal, that is victory. So this is how Sports Day enhances all these kind of things in an institution. The next sports program is Health Runs. Health Runs are organized by the Department of Health or in social organization or both. The main aim of Health Runs is to increase the level, or you can say enhance the level of fitness of the citizens of a country, or if it is organized at a very small scale, it increases the physical fitness of the citizens of a specific state. Health Runs also help various organizations in raising funds for charity, which are later used for the noble cause. Health Runs generally do not require any kind of preparation, as there is no sort of competition, no medals, no trophies. The basic aim is to either enhance the level of health or raise funds for charity. The third sports program is Run for Fun. Run for Fun is basically a program organized by various social organizations which basically have an aim to promote fitness among people. It has a maximum distance of 2.5 kilometers, which is a pretty short distance for running. It spreads a message of remaining healthy in a society or a group of people or a community. It is organized at a very small scale, and for mass participation they also involve various prizes, as the participants, in order to get these prizes, will run sincerely. Run for Unity unites people for a specific purpose. It spreads unity among different castes, religions, group, etc., as people from various religions, various groups, various communities, various traditions, all participate together in a run for unity, and all of these people have a common goal, that is physical fitness, which automatically helps in increasing the amount of unity amongst these kind of people. So, moving on to the last topic of this chapter, that is Run for Cause. These are organized for a noble and a good cause, which basically is raising funds for charity. In these runs, various prizes are given to the position holders, that is to the first, second and third runners. These are basically organized by non-profit organizations, and no share cut is given to the sponsors as well as to the organizers. The best example of these runs is the Mumbai and Chennai Marathon, which are organized annually. These runs are organized to raise funds for the disabled. Various famous personalities like business tycoons, and the best example is actors and actresses. These people also participate, and also they donate a huge amount of money for charity. With this, we are done with the first chapter, that is planning in sports.